Given especially that the lead character is undocumented, I know that's a big part of the show and Home of the Drivers, how do you, as a Latina, feel that this show will resonate, particularly with like undocumented and immigrant youths who may not feel like they're being seen in media?
Absolutely. Something I adore about Jess is that she is just this really, you know, bright young woman who has so much potential. She's smart, and, you know, she wants to make everyone feel loved, and she is just this, she really is just this tenacious young woman. Yes, she's a dreamer, but that is not all she is. And I really do feel that throughout the show, we get to see all these different aspects and layers of who she is underneath a paper, like underneath a citizenship status that, you know, other people may not be able to see past. And so to be able to explore that would be, you know, it's just an honor.
And I gotta say, she kills it. She kills it. She does an amazing job. She's gonna be a huge role model. It's gonna be awesome. I just have to spit that out.
Is there a lot of action, and did you guys have to train for that?
There is a lot of action. There's
a ton of action.
Yeah, every episode just increasingly gets more intense as we go, and I think it kind of kicks off even after episode 5. You see a good amount of action,
yeah.
But after that, it's like
it's very,
you know,
roller coaster, right?
It is a very big roller coaster for sure.
Yeah, like I mean, obviously we can't spoil too much, but it's almost like. It's almost like when you first get taken away, when you step in, you go like, whoa, right? That's like the first bit. And then it's just this.
And then
once it hits, oh my gosh. Like it really doesn't stop. And I just remember we'd get like scripts and we'd just be like, oh, okay, we're going here. Oh my gosh. Like it didn't stop.
Yeah.
You know, it was crazy.
I didn't train.
I was about to say, maybe just
really train for it. But we had good people on our team taking care of us while we were filming, make sure we didn't get hurt.
Oh yeah,
anything,
our stunt department was insane. Russell was amazing.
Yeah,
it was a blast, and I think the audience too is. I would even go as far to say, our action sometimes it parallels the films, or sometimes goes a little above.
Mr. Love the action.
I don't know. I can't give away too much yet, but yeah.
On a scale from 1 to 10, how much do you think the show, like, how much is the show going to cater to history nerds that like are like going to geek out over?
I would say a 10, especially if you're interested in, you know, a different type of history with like the indigenous people that was never told authentically. You know, for me growing up, I never heard the truth about my indigenous culture. I never really understood it because I just was never told in history books, you know? And so I think like now to be able to have the exposure, especially on a show of this scale and for people that are the creators that are honoring it, you know, I think it really is going to make people think, oh my God, yes, that's exactly what happened. You know, when Cortez came over and the indigenous women and men were there originally, you know, they were the founders of this land that they call the United States. So it is great.
And then also we had my goodness, the writers would talk to actual history professors and stuff. Like, we had professionals on this. This is no, like, oh, then let's just say this happened. No. Like, there are so many people that cleared it. I mean, we do not just mess around. We dive into the true history of so much. If you're a history nerd, you will get a full cup. Yeah, that's for sure.
So, as you continue to delve into these characters, is there anything you found you were surprised to learn about yourselves?
Man, yeah, I definitely say, we were kind of talking about this earlier, Liam Sadusky, he's a descendant of Peter Sadusky from the original films, and he's a prime example of how treasure hunting, because we kind of really make it look pretty in the movies, and it's cool, and it's action-packed, and, like, we don't hang too long with severity, and I think what's interesting about Liam's character is they show the real impact of loss that can happen from journeying in this lifestyle, and he wants a lot, like, nothing to do with it, right? And his emotional escape is kind of in music, because he closes himself off to a lot of people, because people he was really close to are just not a part of his life anymore. And I think he was such an emotionally guarded character, and when Jess comes into his life, she kind of pulls him out of that. And I think where I parallel with the character is I normally keep a lot of my stuff in. And Liam and this journey and this amazing cast has kind of helped me be more expressive as myself as well. At least that's a lot of what the show's done for me. You know?
Yeah, I would say I grew into myself as well. I mean, just because she's a person status, she's, you know, programmed to stay under the radar, to not make yourself loud, to not, you know, speak your truth. And I think, you know, for the most part, but for her, I mean, in her family, she's always felt safe, right? So now this adventure takes her outside of her family and having to figure out whether she's willing to risk it all or not, you know, I think, you know, that is part of, like, the, you know, the wish fulfillment, right?
Yeah.
You don't know, like, what are the stakes? Are they worth it? Will I go for it? And I think she was growing into herself and the confidence that she has to do this. And that's kind of what I felt like because of what the job, this job entailed, you know? Yeah.
How far after the movies is this?
About 20 years.
Yeah.
That's about what it was.
Yeah, it's very, as far as the timeline goes, it's, you know, the first two movies were based during that time, and ours is 2022? Yeah, it's, yeah.
About 20.
Yeah, 20, you know, one of the 20s, just pick, you know, we're getting there. Yeah.
And tell us a little bit about the development you guys had as a cast, because, you know, everything, obviously, as you just said, the 20s really haven't existed for a lot of us.
Yeah.
So for you guys, and with the pandemic and everything, it couldn't have been easy to develop even a relationship or a chemistry. So how did you guys go about doing that?
But that's so funny, because we all got casted on Zoom. So we had to do these, like, you know, chemistry reads through Zoom and build the relationship off of there. I mean, I think I don't know if we just got really lucky, but, like, as soon as all of us met, we hit it off.
Yeah.
You know?
And, I got to give it to Jerry and the Wigs and Veronica casting and just, you know, ABC, everyone, just the casting process and putting us all together.
Yeah.
It wasn't difficult. I mean, I remember, like, I've been very blessed to be a part of some amazing cast, but, you know, I'm biased, but this is my family, you know, and I think it kind of happened immediately. Like, we had a group chat going, we're arguing about who's going to be the first to start it.
Yeah.
Because it was only.
I didn't start it.
Yeah, it was only. And she
ended up, no, you ended up starting it.
Oh,
and
right.
Then
I was like, do you want to, should we start it? And she's like, yeah, and I already started it. She's
started,
like, what
happened?
But it was Lisette and I and Zuri were casted first.
Yes.
We were the first round, and then we finally got
up. And then Antonio joined, and then Jordan joined. And then, you know, everyone trickled in from there. And, yeah, it's just been a pleasure to get to work with people who are just so talented and just so their characters as well. And it was awesome.
And it shows in the show.
Like, it does.
I mean, it's pretty insane. I mean, all these people are supposed to know each other for so long. I mean, except Liam. He eventually comes into the group. But their friendship on and off camera, it's not lost on anyone. I think the audience, the minute they see them interacting, are going to get infected with how much fun they have.
And, like, what was your biggest takeaway from this experience?
So many.
That
if you don't give up on what you believe in, if you follow, like, this is obviously it's a tough job, you know, and Liam is a character I've always wanted to see myself as, but I've just always hoped I got the opportunity and never knew it would happen. And so, I mean, this has kind of showed me, to be honest, I know it's, like, on paper it sounds kind of corny, but it is, like, don't let go of your dreams, because I feel like with this cast and the showrunners and the people and Disney, just everyone, it is a dream situation. Like, I mean, that's really what this has shown me. I mean, that's my message for sure, you know?
Yeah, and, you know, I just think I'm really proud of all of us for what we've done. You know, for me and playing this part, I just could only hope that my grandparents and, like, my parents were proud. So, you know, that's, like, the one thing is I hope when they watch it, and even other Latinos, I hope when they watch it, they're proud.
Yeah.